I'm sorry are two of the most powerful words in the English language, and you really shouldn't use them when you're selling your home. I'm going to explain why. This is day 29 of Mark Madness. Hi, and welcome to day 29 of Mark Madness. I'm your host, Mark J. Schmidt of Remax Country and MoveMeMark.com. So, I'm sorry are two of the most powerful words in the English language, and yet you really shouldn't use them while selling your home. Why is that? Well, let me tell you. If you're like most people, you probably take great pride in your home. You know, you've worked hard to have this home. You've probably spent a lot of money maintaining your home and fixing your home up. And then what happens? One day you go to sell your home and you're having a showing. And the buyers come in and they have their agent with them. And maybe you're home for the showing. What some people wind up doing is they start apologizing for things in their home. Because they want people to think that, you know, they've taken good care of their home. So here they go and they say, oh, you know what? I'm sorry there's a crack in the ceiling over there. Oh, I'm sorry that's a mess over here. I'm sorry there's a scuff on the wall. And really what you're doing when you're apologizing for things like that is you're pointing those things out to the buyers for your home. They may never have noticed those things. You know, you could go and say, oh, look, there's a crack on the ceiling. I'm really sorry about that. They may never have noticed that crack in the ceiling. And here you are pointing it out to them. Now, listen, most buyers are pretty savvy. They can tell right away when they go into a home whether a home has been cared for or whether it's falling apart. So that's why I tell my clients, never ever apologize for anything in your home. If the buyers like it, they're gonna like it. If there's a crack, if there's a scuff on the wall, if something's a little messy, they're gonna be able to overlook that. They're really gonna be looking at the big picture. So don't apologize, don't point out the little problems in your home. In fact, I tell my clients, if you can, leave. Don't stay around for showings. Just go out, come back later once the showing is over. It makes things much easier. Now listen, if you have questions about buying or selling a home, please visit my website. You can find me at www.movememark.com. Thanks so much for tuning in today. I really appreciate it. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow for more Mark Madness.